It's your boy Starboy 3, Mr. RIP that pussy. You're now rocking with Amped Up Live.
She done made some plans with my dick. Hey, she go with him on my dick. Hey, sitting on stand on my dick. Hey, she go with him on my.
It's your girl Antonia. We out here at Amped Up Live with a great guest we have in the building. We got Starboy 3.
You.
What it do?
What up, though?
Wow. How did I get lucky to run into you?
I don't know, man. You should play the lottery today.
I am. You know what?
No, I'm like a unicorn. You don't see me everywhere.
Well, I'm a Capricorn, so ain't no cap in here.
Oh, I feel that. Hey,
thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Wow, Starboy 3.
What up?
You in the building.
I'm here.
How? How did you even get here? Like, right now, your name is buzzing. Your tracks, they're buzzing. What's going on? What am I missing? What's the sauce?
I don't know, man. My mother just chose the right baby father, you know. Genetics, you know.
Okay,
good genetics,
okay,
you know.
Okay, okay, okay. He is very handsome,
ladies.
Landed
in the right place. Thank you.
Yes, yes, yes.
Landed in the right place, you know.
You're Jamaican.
Yeah, background.
Wow.
For sure.
Okay. Bad man.
You know, okay. Yad man thing.
Oh, yad man. See, I begin, you know, words confused. Okay, tell me about yourself. Where did you come from? Where did you start?
What you want to know, like, specifically?
Okay, so where did you get your name from? Starboy 3.
One of my homeboys, Seth Lawyer, gave me that name.
Ooh.
I was younger, and he was just like, yo, you're going to be a star one day. And then he just started calling me that, and everybody just started, like, sticking with it. Just stuck, you know?
Wow.
It's one of them things where you can't. I named myself a couple things before, but people stuck with that one, so you
that's
know.
The one, and you gotta go with the people.
You gotta go with the people want, for
right,
sure.
Right, exactly. So, what artists inspired you growing up?
Musically, like a lot. I grew up in a record shop, so I listened to a lot of shit. Directly, I say like Lil Wayne, Jay-Z, and Vibes Cartel and shit like that.
Ooh, fun fact: me and Vibes Cartel got the same birthday.
Dope.
January 7th.
Dope.
Okay. But you're a Libra, so you wouldn't know about that.
Yeah, heavy on the scale, you know.
Heavy on the scale. Okay. Your birthday's coming up.
Yeah.
You got any plans?
Yeah, the 5th. I don't know what I'm doing yet, you know.
October 5th.
I don't know what I'm doing yet.
Okay. Big scale.
I won't probably just do a week of water activities.
That would be lit.
Yeah, I think that's what
that
I'm
would be
going
lit.
To.
So what's home? Is it which state? Like what is home?
Home is where I'm from. Jersey is home.
Oh, but, okay. Shout out to Jersey.
I'm everywhere. I'm all over the place like bird shit. You know what I mean? I'm
what the
fuck? Everywhere. You know what I'm saying?
Wow. I don't want bird shit around me.
But it's all around.
Yeah, it definitely is.
It's all around. You can't miss it. You know what I'm saying? It's everywhere you go, A-State.
Dang, you are absolutely right. You're absolutely right. Coming up, what, as you're, you know, as you're inspired into, or you're in the streets of Jersey and so forth, what made you choose music?
Well, it was always around me. Like I said, I grew up in a record shop.
Right.
So it was just always around me. So it was one of them things that I just kind of gravitated to.
Did you have any challenges?
With what? Music?
Yeah, like.
I mean, not really. I kind of started off with instruments. Mm. Learned how to play certain instruments. Went to musical schools and shit.
Really?
Like that. So, yeah.
Ooh.
Went to performing arts high school, shit like that.
That's lit. What instruments were you?
I started playing percussion.
Ooh.
And then I went to saxophone.
Oh, that's sexy.
Like that.
Okay. That's what's up. Now, if you had something to go back to from your childhood to change, maybe to develop maybe you more as an artist today, what would that be?
I won't change nothing.
No?
Yeah, I'm one of them people. I'm one of them people that believe how shit happened just happened.
Facts.
You feel what I'm saying? So I wouldn't really go back and change nothing. Anything is pretty much a learning experience.
I love that. So I did see, you know, I do my research.
You're vegan. Heavy on the vegan.
How? What made you get into that?
I just wanted to change. I didn't really want no blood in my body and shit like
facts.
That. You know what I'm saying? So I just wanted a whole change. So I just went and just swapped it out. You know what I'm saying?
And when you say no blood in your body, you mean like animal
blood, like no, right. Nothing from an animal. You know what
all
I'm saying?
Those hormones and
yeah,
whatnot.
For sure.
That's why you have like flawless skin, I see.
Thank you,
okay,
thank you.
Okay. Take note.
Yeah, that, you know what I'm saying? That vegan lifestyle, you know.
Now how were you inspired by that? Was it someone or did you just do research?
Oh, well, my brother was vegan pretty much all my life that I knew him and shit.
Oh,
so
wow.
He was he used to cook shit, so I already knew that it was shit that tastes good for vegans, right. And shit wow. like that. So, but then I kind of just was like in the up in the mountains and was by myself and around nature more and shit like that. And I just cut that shit off. I just didn't really want that shit no more.
Wow. So
one of them things.
Yeah, that's awesome. So are you really in tune with yourself spiritually?
Oh yeah, for sure.
Wow. Did you have to come encounter with a situation?
Just being, like I said, just being around nature by myself.
Why were you in nature? Were you?
I just chose to get away and just go up in nature and just, you know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Be around mountains and be around like lakes and, you know, creeks and
different cities, states, or did you choose a particular area?
Northern California.
Wow. Okay. I definitely gotta, you know, go on a little retreat over there, it sounds like.
Beautiful.
Wow. So you're here in Florida now, mm-hmm. and you go back and forth and up north in New Jersey and so forth.
I'm all over like bird shit.
Which one of those cities do you see yourself more utilizing as your career as an artist?
Well, between LA for sure.
Why is that?
It's just because I'm more tapped in with everything that's going on in LA.
Right.
And my LA circle is kind of like already, you know what I'm saying? So,
yeah.
Kind of just tapped in with LA.
That's cool.
Musically.
Yeah. You have a hit track right now. Not right now. That's going to be a track for a minute because I also, you know.
The Dick Will Never Die.
Oh my gosh.
Dick Will Never
Die. Can
I
introduce the song or the words? Like.
It will never die. It ain't going nowhere.
Wait.
For a long time.
Wait. So let's explain.
Yeah.
If you're now tuning in and don't know what's going on, there's a track he has. You've had that track for before 2019, I assume, for like 2-3 years.
Yeah, for sure.
2-3 years, right? This track called.
Go on, say it.
Dick. Yeah. Okay. Hot track. Hot. Very hot.
Thank you.
Very hot. And now, how did you come about? Well, I don't even want to know, all right? I don't even want to know that. How? Okay. You have a couple of featured artists. I saw you first. You have Doja Cat. That's pretty
for
awesome.
For sure, my sister.
Yes. How did you do that?
I've been working with Doja Cat for a minute.
Wow. How did you learn anything from just working with her?
Oh, for sure. Like, she's super herself. You know what I'm saying? So if anything, I took from her, just be yourself.
Yes.
For sure. She'll scale like me. So.
So you was working with her before this track?
Yeah, for sure.
Wow.
I was on tour with her. I was opening for her on the Amala tour. And we worked before that. I opened up a couple of days for her before that, and then I opened up days for her after that.
That's awesome. Right. So when you utilize that, you know, that connection, how can you, I guess, take advantage of that when it comes to other opportunities?
As far as like what?
The experience, I guess. Just going on tour, meeting artists.
Oh yeah, going on tour for sure. Like you learn how to deal with every crowd differently. You know what I'm saying?
Right,
every crowd
ain't
the same. You know what I'm saying? Across the states, across wherever, everybody don't react to everything the same. So, you know, you kind of learn different things, especially opening. You learn different things, what to do to kind of like get the crowd going before you even get on stage.
Right,
and,
right.
You know, things not to have happen before you get on stage and shit like that to make everything go smooth. So you kind of learn a lot.
That makes sense. That makes a lot of sense. Now, did you know Ludacris was going to hop on that?
Yeah.
How? I mean, maybe it was more a surprise for me, obviously, because I'm not you, but come on. Like, that's another GOAT right there.
For sure.
That's wild.
For sure. You know, you got to surround yourself with the GOATs.
Facts.
You know.
I'm checking out your discography. I don't see a solid album on there. You're just releasing tracks?
Yeah, I just been releasing tracks.
Wow.
I used to put out mixtapes before, like
2015,
2016.
Yeah. I'm not a sucker.
Your homework. That's pretty good. But like 2015, 2016, I was putting out mixtapes, and then I like just started releasing singles, and then just kept going with the singles. And,
that's lit. Obviously, you're doing your music 2015, 2016, leading into 2019. Boom, the pandemic hits. How did that affect you? How do you feel that affected you? Were you able to do any?
I was outside.
What about performing wise?
Yeah, that's for sure.
How did
shows? No shows for sure.
So how were you able to manage to even make funds
just
from that? Or
just stay working, and you know, you have investments that you have before and shit like that. And just stay working.
Okay.
And staying positive so that you know this shit don't really fuck with you mentally, and keep going
that.
And just knowing that everything gonna work out. You know, I never once let this shit stop me. Not one drop. I was outside this whole time.
Right.
Thank God I never caught that shit. But you know. Just kept it moving.
Gotta do what you gotta do.
Yeah, for sure.
I love that.
You only got one life. You're gonna die, you're gonna die.
Right.
Walk outside, get hit by a motherfucking bus. No fuck gonna happen.
Yeah, Holly. Damn.
It's a fact.
No, it's true.
Waking up is a risk.
Oh, for sure. Getting in your car, going outside, you never know.
For sure.
You never know. But it's all about, you know, taking that chance or that, you know, risk. So yeah. Because it can open up more opportunities.
Are you gonna do what you're gonna do, or are you gonna stay put?
Right. Right.
Yeah,
right.
You said this was just one of them things.
No, for sure.
Right.
What's an awkward moment you had, like, or an encounter you had with a fan? Have you ever had one? You look like you have.
Nah, I don't really.
No.
Like I said, I pop out when I need to pop out, and when I kind of pop out, kind of like kind of in the cut. So I don't really have awkward situations like
good.
That.
That's good. People are awkward nowadays.
Nah, for sure.
So you gotta
and I
careful.
Know that, and that's why I move the way I move. Like I said,
you have
when I pop
to.
Out, I'm in the cut.
Yeah.
And
That's good. Where do you see your career going? And
to
know?
The moon.
Oh, dang. You just knew where I was taking it.
Of course. It's not a thought process anymore. You know what I'm saying?
Golly.
No longer a thought process. It's like,
straight
where else is it going
to
go?
That's good.
You know what
so what's some advice you can give to an artist that's inspiring, that wants to be, you know, connected? Like, not many people can say, hey, I have a feature with Ludacris or Doja Cat, and still you're not even dropping, like, pushing heavy, like, solid albums. You're just doing you, like, you're living. How can an artist that's watching this now say, dang, what can I do to
just keep going? You don't never know what the fuck gonna happen. You know what I'm saying? Just keep going. Like, you can't plan this shit out. You know what I'm saying? You can.
Yeah.
You can write it out how you want it done. You know what I'm saying? It's good to have a plan, but you don't really know how this shit gonna go. You just gotta keep working. You know what I'm saying? It's like one of them things. You just gotta keep. If you don't throw no punches, then
right,
you ain't got no chance of knocking the motherfucker out. You gotta throw some punches. You gotta keep going.
Gotta do what you gotta do.
For sure.
Have you been back to Jamaica?
And I haven't been to Jamaica since 2014, but I plan on going this year.
This year? Ooh, that's going to be fun.
Yeah, for sure.
That's going to be lit. What part are you going to go to?
Spanish Town, for sure.
Ooh. So how was the culture in Jamaica and, like, infiltrated your culture here or your music?
I mean, I've been around it my whole life, so it's everything I know.
Do you speak patois or?
Of course.
Oh, say something.
Something.
Okay. Okay. I'll just go there. So what other artists are you looking forward to working with?
Anybody dope. I like dope people or animated people and shit. You know what I'm saying? I really like animated people.
You are animated though. Your song. You have this track. I love Step and Easy 3. Was it Easy 3? Is it Easy 3?
Yeah,
yes. Freestyle. Those are. When I was listening to it, I was like, what the? Oh, my God. And that's who you are.
Oh, yeah, just what you hear in the music is exactly what I am.
And
you
I can see why Doja was like, oh, yeah, this track is fun. That's a fire track. I would really appreciate if you guys put a visual to that together.
Gotta stick around and see what might happen. You never know.
I mean, I shoot videos, so I can help y'all.
You never know.
Dang.
Expect the unexpected.
That's going to be awesome. But you are very animated. Very.
For sure. Like,
but how? Like,
nobody likes a boring person.
So
do you like a boring person?
Hell no.
Nobody likes a boring person. I don't. Nobody likes a boring
Dang.
Person. So if you walk in the room and you don't leave your impact, you might as well not walk in there.
Right. Better just go on home.
Yeah, just stay your ass in the house. Stay your boring ass in the house.
Damn. Keep sending me that. Doesn't mean that.
No, I definitely do. Oh, like, if you go in the room and you don't leave your impression, stay your boring ass in the house.
So how can someone leave an impression? How can somebody leave a mark when you're...
Don't be afraid to be yourself.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? And if you just... Some people don't know who they are. You might have to find who the fuck you are first before you go step in the rooms and shit. Right. You know what I'm saying? But figure out who the fuck you is.
For sure.
And step in the motherfucking rooms with confidence and just be your motherfucking self.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, for sure.
Just don't be boring.
For sure. Wow. So what is STARBOI 3? Is that like a 3 area code? Or, well, area code is 3 digits.
It's just a 3.
Oh. My favorite number is 7.
My favorite number is 3.
Okay.
I like the 7 though too. Okay. I fucks with the 7.
See, but you gotta pick one when you choose 3.
Nah, it's 3 for sure.
Okay, like, STARBOI 7.
Nah, it don't have that ring. The 3, you know what I'm saying? STARBOI 3.
And it's still dope too, because you can even make a 3 like an E. And people still would say STARBOI. But they won't. If they know, they'll know it's STARBOI 3.
If you know, you know.
Exactly.
You know?
You know the vibes.
Most definitely.
Word. What's a quote you can leave us with? You know, something that you want people, or even a quote or a message that was given to you, an advice or something. That took you, you know, took a part, played a part, maybe to yourself.
You want me to leave a quote? Don't be Jim.
Don't be what?
Don't be Jim.
Jim? Yes.
Don't be Jim, bro.
Oh, my goodness. Don't end up like Jim.
Ladies.
Well, fellas, don't end up like Jim, because your lady might be in the gym.
For sure.
With him tonight.
For sure. Working out. Doing all types of shit.
Yes. Yes. Golly.
Calisthenic ab works.
Flexing on him.
You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Got in there doing squats.
Dang. So you just... I don't even open that door.
Go ahead.
No, we're not going to do that here today on Hands Up Live.
Go ahead.
I just want to know, like, we're done here.
I ain't scared to answer a motherfucking thing.
No, there's nothing that's laid out to be said. We're going to wait for the next interview. Sorry, he's not Jim.
Nah.
No.
Never could be Jim.
No.
Never could be him.
Never.
You know what I'm
Tell
saying?
Tell him. But yeah, I wanted this, you know, to have you come out here and let us know who you are, check you out, because your numbers are going up. It's going crazy. You got like 40 million monthly listeners. Like, you're doing it.
Shout out to the people.
Facts. Shout out to your fans.
Yeah, shout out to the fans. I like to say the fans. Shout out to the supporters.
Supporters.
Shout out to the supporters.
Yeah.
Shout out to the people. Gotcha. Running the dick to the moon, you know what I'm saying? Making sure the dick don't die.
Wow, now you know everybody after this song is gonna be getting pregnant. Can't say
well,
the
that's
gym
what it was
membership.
Made for.
Wow.
Yeah, that's what it was made for.
Wow, man. It's a new era for when you know.
But, for sure.
Wow. All right. Well, I definitely want to thank you for coming through.
No problem.
Doing your thing.
No problem.
You're definitely inspiring. I love that. You know. You are on the go. The pandemic didn't slow you down.
Not one drop.
You know, you're very alive. You know, it's motivating. So I hope that this, you know, conversation we're having, this session, will continue to go further.
Thanks. And salute to you. And salute to you. And shout out to your platform.
Thank
you.
You
know, having this dope thing set
Thank
up.
You
know, being able to run this shit.
Thank you. You're the man. Thank you so much for coming through. And yeah, make sure you know, hit him up, STARBOI 3. Find him everywhere, all streaming platforms, social media platforms, everything.
Make sure you go stream that dick. New music coming soon, but the dick will never die. Run it up to the moon.
Guys, this song is called Dick.
Nah, for sure. If you don't know, you must live on the motherfucking rock or something.
Hey.
That's a fish act.
I love it. I love that song.
Thank you.
I hope you're not watching this, Mom.
Mom might know the song, too.
She might.
Respectfully.
Nah, we gotta go later. Oh, hell no!